So, I'm going to give you a demo of two pieces of software. The first is called the GBIF name parser, and the other is the IPAN taxonomic name resolution service. Both of these services will help you to assess a list of plant names. The GBIF name parser will help you parse any scientific name, but particularly the taxonomic name resolution service made available by IPAN. Only works right now with plant names. So, let's start with the name parser. As I introduced to you yesterday during the assessments, ways to assess presentation, it helps you atomize scientific names into their different parts. So, that's the genus, species, subspecies, or in other words, genus, specific epithet, and subspecific epithet. And there's also the authorship as well. So for this demonstration, I thought I would have a nice list of names for you to see. And I'd like to run those through the GBIF name parser to see if they are valid names or not. Now, looking at this list of names, is there anybody that can tell me if there's maybe one or two that look suspicious, that look doubtful? Part of a well-defined scientific name is that the genus name is capitalized. So if you took, for example, the third from the top, Barbaria cristata L. The genus is Barbaria, and it's capitalized. And then the species name, cristata, is in lowercase. So this is an example of a well-formed name. You've got the genus, you've got the species, and authorship. Now, are there any on this list that don't follow that rule? Can anybody spot one where maybe the species name, the second name in the name, is not lowercase? Anybody? Don't be shy. There's no wrong answers. Ah, we have somebody in the back. The fifth one? Or the sixth one? The fifth one. Crested Philippine violet. Yes, you're right. That looks very suspicious. That's a good answer. Are there any other names up there? The second name. The last one, right? Yeah, exactly. Because it's the second name is not capitalized, right? So it's not. Also, it's got a suspicious looking author, if that's what you call the author. So let's check it out. Let's try and run this through the name parser so that we can tell what is a well-structured name and what is not. Okay? Maybe we should just try one first so that we can see. Alright? Actually, remember on day one, there was that example of a scientific name that John had in his exercise? In the Dongkor Napping exercise? Remember it was this name here? And it had this this subspecies rank in there. And we were a little confused whether or not it was valid or not. Let's try and run this one. And this is how it works. you just drop your list of names inside the box, and then you press parse. So it's very simple. So there's a simple table, and then there's also an extended table. Let's just start with the simple table first. So we've got our original name here. We've got our genus. We've got our specific epithet, which looks right. And we've also got the subspecies rank. Let me extend. So you can see it gives you some additional information. It gives you a type. And I'll get to that in a second. There are a bunch of different result types. And it will give you the canonical form of the name. And it will also allow you to do a lookup search on the GBIF checklist bank web services to see whether or not that name exists then, and whether or not there are any known usages of it in other general or thematic checklists in the world. We've got a question from Javier.
Shouldn't the infrastructure field have something?
Yes. I would have expected it to be populated as well. So it seems that something hasn't quite gone right yet. Maybe it's a little rich, but not sure. Yes, indeed. It seems to fail on this subspecies. Actually, let me just revise the documentation. Ignores additional infraspecific parts, such as species. Okay, so I think that's on purpose. So we can ignore that for now. So we've got the rest of our list, okay? And we've got our two doubtful names that we're not really sure about. So why don't we try and drop the entire thing into the name parser and see what happens. Is that clear enough? Can everybody see? Is it big enough, first of all? Can people see it? Alright, so it might be a little bit difficult to read, but let's try. I'll show the extended form. So, we thought there were two doubtful names. We thought it was this one, and this one, the fifth one, and then the second one. So this was one of the examples, right? It thought, okay, the first one must be the genus. And then it said, okay, everything after that, since it's capitalized, must indeed be the authorship. And it gave you a parsing type of doubtful, which flags it to you and says, oh, this probably isn't a well-defined scientific name. Then there was the other one that didn't even have a capitalized genus name to begin with, but it had a capitalized specific epithet, and that certainly doesn't look like any kind of authorship to me, and it doesn't even run through, it's completely ignored, basically. And to give you some background, that's just a common name to one of the species on this list, okay? But for the rest of these names, it actually looks like it's done quite a good job. We have the genus, specific epithet, and authorship. Same thing here. The difference between these two names, Bralaria crostata and Bralaria crostata, that looks suspicious, but it's not the job of the name parser to tell me whether or not these names are actually valid, accepted names or not, whether or not they're spelled correctly. It's just about the structure of the name. So right away you can get some errors cleaned up right here and now, and it's very beneficial. Okay? Question from Tom.
Yeah, sorry. Aren't you worried about information loss with that subspecies epithet blanking out on the third from the last line? Which is to say, why would that be intentionally omitted?
I'm going to look into that, and I will get back to you guys.
Okay, thanks.
It's a good point. I was hoping nobody would bring that up. Anyway, I'm going to go back to the presentation where I present.
I have a second account class.
What's that?
I have a second account class.
Yeah, of course.
The subspecies of the cat is the cat and the lion.
Oh. Let's try it again. This time. Making it lower gas. And I'm going to hope and pray that it shows up this time. I have a feeling John was needed. There it is. Success. So, that's an indication that if we get the the rank in there, but we don't get the input specific part, that there must have been some kind of structural integrity problem with that name. That's great. So you and I learned something there. Thank you very much, John. So on this slide, it gives you the results from the parser. Everything in green passed with flying colors. Everything in red was either doubtful or untyped, unrecognizable. And then we have that one that was left over, the one with the subspecies. It was capitalized wrongly. And I just left that one blank. But now we all know that if you make the subspecific epithet lowercase, that it actually is a valid name and goes through with flying colors, so we return that one in green as well. Alright, so that's all the GBIF name parser does. And there are other tools out there that do a similar thing, but actually I like this one better because it gives you the parsing type. It lets you know whether or not it was well formed, or whether or not it was doubtful, whether or not it contained hybrid formulas. And for that reason, I do prefer this tool.